Okay. The short-term loss offset short-term gain. The long-term loss offset long-term gain. It's very complicated. If we have time, we may go over the Schedule D, if we have time. For those of you, if you have a computer with you, get online the IRS.org, and you just download the Schedule D for the 1040. Schedule D, D like David. And also, for this year, I think there's a new form. I believe it's not really, it's for so many years already. It's called A949. Okay. A949, for those of you, I believe most of you may use this. For those of you, you sell stock in 2011, or you sell any capital assets last year, then you need to report Schedule D. You need to file Schedule D. And the Schedule D require you to file the form A949 together. And this is the list to tell the IRS which stock, what is the cost, and what is the price you sell. And eventually from last year, I believe, the stockbroker by law required to provide you the statement. In the past, you don't have the statement, so you need to go back to so many years to find out what is your original cost. And right now, the tax law requires the stockbroker to provide you. Whenever the investor sold the stock, the brokerage, the broker firm required to provide you the statement to indicate what is the original cost you purchased. You just transfer the number from your statement to here. So this is the form A949. All right. So for those of you, you sold stock or any other capital assets in 2011, and Schedule D and the form A949 are those two forms you need to use. Yes.
Do they have a limit?